The men, you have all to that time? Me. Takes you 20 minutes to go to the men's room? Give me a break. Well, actually, we didn't miss you.
I had to erase your number that was written on the wall.
Number on the wall. we had a good time while you were gone, Brian. Yeah. Me and the rooster.
Well, I hope you enjoy yourself. I hope you really enjoy yourself.
You don't care if your job's in jeopardy or anything.
My job's now in jeopardy. With this Hammond Egger, he couldn't carry my coat.
I won't carry anything of yours anymore, will I?
I won't carry you either anymore.
You never did.
Boy, are the sparks flying here. It's unbelievable. It's all happening right here on Primetime Wrestling.
You like this stuff, don't you?
What?
That's why you have him as a guest. You just like to stir that soup.
Well,
it was either
him or Damien too. Which do you prefer?
I might have, but...
What do you...
I don't... All kinds of things. Right now, we're going to go to the event center with Sean Mooney, and then we'll be back with the Bushwhackers. Back, folks, and we got plenty more excitement left in this edition of Primetime Wrestling. In fact, we're going to take a look in mere moments at two individuals from New Zealand, from down under, referring to the Bushwhackers. These guys don't have a manager, Brian. You could.
Oh, that's right. They don't. I want to make a statement here. I've taken my glasses off. I realize he's going to be no violence now. He's content with getting away with what he got away with. But, you know, I was thinking something. Maybe I acted a little too hastily. Maybe I talked to you like I shouldn't have talked to you. Maybe you didn't need somebody shoving you around talking to you like you were a piece of garbage. Maybe you needed a pat on the back.
That's how you treated everybody.
Well, some people react differently to a pat on the back than a kick in the can. Okay, I was wrong, maybe. I'm a big enough man.
You were wrong? It came out of your mouth?
I admit it on national television. I'm a human being. I made a mistake.
Well,
how about you're going to be here,
like I suggested,
and you keep harping on me? Fine. You go your way, I'll go mine. I was wrong, I apologize.
Oh, how about a handshake?
Great. You're asking for a lot now.
Well, this is an apology and a handshake. You two gentlemen, I think that it's only fitting.
Okay, it's over then.
Oh, yeah.
It's over.
Yes, sir.
I like to
for
see
good.
I like to
I'm through with you, you're through with me.
Yes.
I made a mistake.
Sounds good to me.
Forget it.
Not very often, he apologizes.
Okay. Guaranteed. Forget it.
Okay.
Oh, what? Why are you doing that?
Well, nothing.
Why would you do that?
Come on, Lombardi. Get him. Choke him. Pull him out there. Choke him. Slam him. Kick him. Right through there. Choke him now. Choke him. Here's your hat. Don't forget your hat. Now show what a tough guy is. Taylor.
Rooster.
How you doing, Rooster?
Hey, lady.
You're on, Bobby.
Well, let's get back to normal here. Let's get back to business. Business of Primetime Wrestling. Well, I've taken over my... you might say host position here on Primetime Wrestling. I'd like to explain to you humanoids out there, and I don't even know why you deserve an explanation, but I'll explain to you exactly what took place here. You think for 1 minute that I'm going to sit out here on this show, Primetime Wrestling on USA Network, the show that I made famous, and let a guy like Rooster, Terry Taylor, come out here and sit here and along with Gorilla Monsoon make fun of me, talk about me, and treat me like an imbecile? You're dealing with the wrong kind of bird, pal. This is Bobby the Brain Heenan. What happened is Steve Lombardi, probably the toughest human being walking the streets, is now associated with Bobby the Brain Heenan. Oh, this man's never won a match in his life. He hasn't even come close on a lot of occasions in that ring. Why? Because he's too concerned with the referees and getting disqualified and losing the winner's share of the money. I explained to him, you're the toughest guy walking the streets. You don't have to worry about when you get in that ring. You listen to me. I'll take a guy like you who's never won a match, and I'll make you wealthy. I'll make you a star. He said, that's fine. You just pay me. I don't care if you yell at me, kick me, do whatever you want. Just make me money. I said, fine, Lombardi. Because you're a brawler and you're from Brooklyn. So, as a matter of fact, you're the Brooklyn Brawler. That's your new name. You're the Brooklyn Brawler. As far as Gorilla Monsoon is concerned, he just got in the way. I never meant nothing to happen to him. The brawler meant nothing to happen to him. But Taylor, it was planned for you, pal. So now let's go see the Bushwhackers wrestle. I'll have more in a little while from the host.
What? Go ahead, Bobby, you're on.
Well, I still haven't heard about the... Well, point. That's what you're there for. Don't just yell camera one, two, or three. You got everything turned around here. Gonna make me look like a fool. Well, we still haven't heard the condition of Gorilla Monsoon. He went out with some of the World Wrestling Federation personnel. Like I said before, Gorilla, I personally apologize to you. You are not meant to be involved in anything that happened here. You just got in the way. Had you maintained your seat and kept your mouth shut, you'd still be here. But I'm sorry for what happened to you, but not for what happened to you, Mr. Rooster. Well, you just saw the Bushwhacker shopping. Now, wouldn't you like to own a store and see them walk into your place? Well, we have coming up here right now, yes, a match now to that camera, Mr. Perfect, courtesy of Saturday Night Main Event, Wrestling Coco Beware. How's that?
What a matchup. Look at
over here, Bobby. Right here.
Well, then get over there, then. Hey, you with the headsets, I want you to let me know the minute that you hear on those headsets that Gorilla Monsoon is coming back here. I want to know the very minute and very second he enters this building or enters the studio where he's at. Well, now we're going to have a very nice segment. I know all you people are going to enjoy it as much as I enjoy it. And had the Rooster paid a little attention to this man, he'd be a lot better off. Ah, yes, I'm talking about my good friend, Brother Love. And he's going to be having a nice little don't switch cameras on me. Chit-chat with the Honky Tonk Man and Greg the Hammer Valentine. Music for Brother Love. Well, Brother Love is a man who enjoyed talking with Jimmy Hart, enjoyed talking with the Honky Tonk Man and Greg the Hammer Valentine. And if everybody would pay a little more attention to Brother Love, this would be a lot better world to live in. Macho Madness Cup. Those are nice. See, the most important thing you have to understand in professional wrestling is you don't double-cross people. And a friend in need is a pest. If you don't believe me, ask the Rooster if he can talk. Towards the end of the program, I'm going to have my Brooklyn Brawler out here sitting right over here. And he's going to be discussing with you humanoids exactly what happened. Oh, he's a new man. You can bet on it. Courtesy of the Brain. Let's go do something.
Call now.
Don't put things right in front of me when I'm trying to conduct an interview here. Run this show. Everything out of here. Well, the match coming up is going to be with Brutus the Barber Beefcake, one of the big jerks in the World Wrestling Federation, against Jacques Rougeau. Now, before I go into that, I still would like to apologize personally to Gorilla Monsoon. Whatever happened is between him and the Brooklyn Brawl. I meant for nothing to happen to him. I understand I'm going to be showing a little more of what happened here. But you're going to be seeing Brutus the Barber against Jacques Rougeau.